Welcome to HW News. This is me, Arti. It's official now. After months of uncertainty looming over its head, the BS Yediyurappa government in Karnataka can finally take a sigh of relief. The Karnataka bypolls have cemented BS Yediyurappa's fate. Total 15 assembly constituencies went for bypolls in Karnataka. It was necessitated after the MLAs belonging to the Congress-JDS camp and independents resigned, which brought down the number in assembly. The rebel MLAs were disqualified, but the Supreme Court judgment last month allowed them to contest the bypolls. 16 of them joined the BJP later. The party in turn fielded 13 of them in the bypoll elections. These candidates were contesting from the same constituency as they did in 2018, but this time on a Lotus ticket. And as it turns out in the results today, the risky gamble has paid off well for the BJP. On December 5, bypolls were conducted on 15 assembly constituencies in Karnataka. These constituencies were Athani, Kagwad, Gokak, Yellapur, Hirekurur, Ranebennur, Vijayanagar, Chikkaballapur, K.R. Puram, Yashwantpur, Mahalakshmi Layout, Shivajinagar, Hoskote, K.R. Pet, and Hunsur. Now, out of the 15 constituencies going to the bypolls, 12 were held by the Congress and 3 were held by the JDS. As I said, the BJP fielded 13 of the rebel MLAs again in the bypolls. A total number of 165 candidates were in the fray for bypolls from all of the 15 constituencies. Most of the constituencies that went for the bypolls were facing a direct contest between Congress and the BJP, but in the southern part of the state, the JDS comes into the picture, making it a triangular fight. During the campaign, the BJP sought votes from locals for stability, while the Congress and JDS urged the electorate to defeat the disqualified legislatures responsible for the collapse of their coalition government in July. Now, interestingly, Congress and JDS, which ran a government together till the collapse caused by the rebellion, decided to fight the elections separately. The Congress, inspired by events in Maharashtra, believed that even in the Karnataka, the local voters will defeat the rebels. In Maharashtra Assembly elections, a lot of leaders who jumped the ship from NCP and Congress to BJP and Shiv Sena had to face a brutal defeat. Congress felt that same would repeat in Karnataka. They also did not tie up with the JDS, their post-poll alliance partner after 2018, thus giving a strength to the stability pitch of the BJP. As of now, the picture has become very much clear. BJP has emerged victorious on 12 seats, whereas Congress has won only 2 seats. An independent candidate has won 1 seat. Now let us also look at the list of winning candidates. From Athani, BJP's Mahesh Kumathalli has emerged as winner. From Kagwad, BJP's Shrimant Patil is the winner. From Gokak, BJP's Ramesh Jarkiholi has emerged victorious. From Yellapur, BJP's Shivram Hebbar is the winner. From Hirekurur, BJP's B.C. Patil is the winner. From Ranebennur, Arun Kumar of the BJP has won this seat. Anand Singh has won Vijayanagar. He is also a BJP candidate. From Chikkaballapur, it is Dr. Sudhakarar of BJP who has won the election. From K.R. Puram, BJP's Bairathi Basavaraj has won. From Yashwantpur, BJP's S.T. Somashekhar has won the election. BJP's K. Gopalaya has won the election from Mahalakshmi Layout. Congress's Rizwan Arshad has won from Shivajinagar, which has been a stronghold for the Congress. It was a very smooth victory for Rizwan Arshad. In Hoskote, independent Sharad Bachegowda has won. In K.R. Pet, BJP's Narayan Gowda has emerged victorious. In Hunsur, Congress's H.P. Manjunath has emerged victorious. Now it's interesting, right after 2018 Karnataka election results, the Congress made quick moves and made a pact with the JDS. It made a post-poll alliance with the JDS and promised chief ministerial post to H.D. Kumaraswamy. In this way, the party managed to contain the BJP, which emerged as the single largest party, from forming the government in the state. The swearing-in ceremony of Kumaraswamy saw much fanfare and opposition unity. However, only few months into the coalition government, it was understood that all was not well with the post-poll alliance partners. At times, H.D. Kumaraswamy cried in front of the public. Once he even said that as a chief minister, his life is not at all the best. Only he knew about the hardships he goes through.
ತಾವುಗಳು ಹೂಗುಚ್ಚಗಳನ್ನು ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ನನಗೆ ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಅಭಿನಂದನೆ ಸಲ್ಲಿಸಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರೀತಿಯಿಂದ ಬಂದ್ರಿ. ಆದರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರನ್ನ ನಾನು ಕೂರಿಸಿ ಒಂದು ಕಡೆ ಗೌರವ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಮಾತನಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗದೇ ಇರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಕ್ಷಮೆ ಕೋರ್ತೀನಿ. ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಸಂತೋಷದಲ್ಲಿದ್ದೀರಿ, ಏನೋ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಅಣ್ಣನೋ ತಮ್ಮನೋ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾನೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ, ಆದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಸಂತೋಷದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲ. ನನ್ನ ಒಂದು ನೋವೇನಿದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ನಾನೇ ಆ ನೋವನ್ನ ವಿಷಕಂಠನಾಗೆ ನುಂಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬಯಸ್ತೇನೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ನಾನು ಈ ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಬಯಕೆ ಇಟ್ಟಿದ್ದು, ಈ ನಾಡಿನ ಜನತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮನವಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಯಾಗಿ ಮೆರೆಯಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಈ ನಾಡಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಈ ನನ್ನ ಪಕ್ಷದ ಒಂದು ಬದ್ಧತೆ ಏನಿದೆ, ಕಮಿಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಏನಿದೆ, ನನ್ನ ತಂದೆಯ ಅನ್ಫಿನಿಶ್ಡ್ ಅಜೆಂಡಾ ಏನಿದೆ, ಈ ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಈ ದೇಶದ ರೈತರಿಗೆ, ಕೂಲಿ ಕಾರ್ಮಿಕರಿಗೆ, ಬಡವರಿಗೆ ಜಾತಿ ಭೇದ ಮರೆತು ಪಕ್ಷ ಭೇದ ಮರೆತು ಅವರ ಕಷ್ಟಗಳನ್ನು ಬಗೆಹರಿಸ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಂದು ಜನಪರವಾದಂಥ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ತರಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ನನ್ನ ಬಯಕೆ ಇತ್ತು.
ನೌ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮರ್ಸಿ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್. I am responsible for the development of the state. That is different. But whatever I have to do my job as a chief minister, I have to take permission from Congress leaders. Without taking permission from them, I can't do anything. They have given me the support. That context I told.
This very much indicated that the alliance, though was functioning, but had very serious flaws. However, both the Congress and JDS were unable to resolve it, and thus, even in the bypolls, both of them fought separately. Thus, Congress, just believing that Maharashtra-type voting will be seen in the bypolls, was just a wishful thinking. After the drubbing now, two senior leaders, former Chief Minister and current CLP leader, Siddaramaiah, and KPCC President Dinesh Gundu Rao have resigned. But the point today we are making here connects us to Maharashtra. In a lot of ways, the Maharashtra Assembly election results reminded us of the Karnataka election results. Be it the way Governor carried out his duties or how the single largest party, BJP, was kept at bay by the other three parties, Congress, ShivSena and NCP. These three parties have internal alliance issues just like Congress and JDS faced in Karnataka. The three parties, though they have won the battle on the floor of Assembly, the real test would be how they will manage to survive the challenge of formation of cabinet and running a government free of controversy, free of internal bickering. It has been more than a week since Uddhav Thackeray and five others were sworn in as the chief minister and ministers respectively. But still, nobody knows which ministry they would be taking charge of. The winter session of Maharashtra Vidhan Sabha will start on 16th December and end on 21st December. Just for 5 days, and yet there is no minister decided. The alliance partner NCP, Congress and ShivSena are not yet able to zero in on the posts and the ministries. Will the alliance have more trouble in the future? Well, that is for the time to tell. But one thing is certain, the Karnataka Assembly election results have a lesson for the new coalition in Maharashtra. Do let us know what you think in the comment box below. For more news and updates, you can log on to www.hwnews.in. Now you can also download our HW News app on your Android Play Store and Apple Store. Also, do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We are just few subscribers away from the milestone of 1 lakh subscribers. So do subscribe to our YouTube channel. Do not forget to like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter. Now be the first to know about the latest updates on our new news app. Go on your Android or iOS, search for HW News Network. Download our app, choose the language you prefer to get updates in, and be up to date with the latest news.